brutally killed 29-year-old Alicia Hummel. 6 years following her murder near Vermilion, her family is no closer to getting the answer. The place and timing of Alicia's death is shocking. Unbelievable that somebody could get away with it. In tonight's Keloland News investigation, Angela Kennecke uncovers new details about the events leading up to Alicia's death and what evidence was left behind.
All the selfies that she takes.
Alicia Hummel was beloved by her friends and family.
It was one of those relationships I probably will never find again. You called Alicia and Alicia was there.
She was the best aunt, like the best aunt ever. You know, to my firstborn.
No fear. That's the one thing I always worried about. Just didn't seem to fear things.
It was that lack of fear that meant Alicia didn't think twice about going fishing by herself, leaving her grandparents' home in Sioux City on June 1st, 2015. The preschool teacher posted on her Facebook page that morning, "First day of vacay, I'm going fishing." Alicia began sharing her excursion on Snapchat. One of her first snaps, when your pole doesn't fit in your car. She took another picture as she drove into South Dakota, and then yet another as she entered Myron Grove and pulled up near the dock. Finally, "I've been waiting since fall," she shared.
Going fishing was a way to clear her mind. If you go to Myron Grove, you'll see the beauty of Myron Grove. It's a very beautiful place.
A beautiful place that turned ugly minutes after Alicia arrived. Her last text was at 1:45 p.m. She wrote to a friend,
"It's a great day to get it on," or something to that effect, the effect of two people having sex. She saw two people having sex.
Some 30 minutes later, a South Dakota Game Fish and Parks employee spotted Alicia's body in the water next to the dock.
It's frustrating how fast everything happened.
Jan and Dwayne Folkers raised their two granddaughters, Alicia and Erica. Jan will never forget the phone call she got from a detective informing her about Alicia's death.
He broke up and he says, "We're going to catch this son, this SOB." He stopped himself.
They told you they were going to catch her killer.
Yeah.
Leaving no stone unturned, Clay County Sheriff's deputies continue to search through the tall grass about a half mile from where Alicia Hummel's body was found, looking for anything that will lead them to her killer.
But as the years pass and no killer is caught, Alicia's family is filled with doubt.
It's awful. And it's sad to think that it's been 6 years to know that it's like we still have closure. We have no closure at all.
There are people that we have not ruled out. We do have suspects, but we don't have a case.
Clay County Sheriff Andy Howe has worked with the DCI and the FBI to try to solve Alicia's murder.
The death was caused by drowning, and then additionally she had blunt force trauma and incised wounds to her neck.
That sounds like a pretty violent crime.
Yes, we believe it was very violent, yeah.
So people who usually commit violent crimes, you consider it an act of passion, something that maybe somebody knew her?
We don't have any indication that that was the case, that this was anything other than a stranger, a crime of opportunity.
While law enforcement contends that Alicia may have seen something that day that she shouldn't have, those close to her have a hard time believing it was a random act.
"I'm going to bash your head in, and I'm going to make sure I'm going to slit your throat, and then I'm going to throw you in water. Like, I got to kill you three ways."
Investigators first looked at what was going on in Alicia's personal life. She was estranged from her husband, Tony, and the couple was preparing to divorce. Bethany had introduced Alicia to Tony in high school.
"You just hope it's really bad coincidences that, you know, they were talking about divorce and we're going to go potentially sign papers in the next week."
Investigators say that Tony Hummel has an alibi. He was in Pierre at the time of Alicia's death. Tony has since moved out of state and did not respond to our attempts to contact him. Whoever killed Alicia left very few clues. The state worker who found her body and a nearby resident saw a vehicle leaving the area, but only had a vague description.
Just a dark car?
A dark car.
That's all you got?
Very little information, no model.
They told me about a pair of shoes that were found there. Men's shoes that the one investigator said resemble shoes that you would wear in a restaurant.
It'd be strange to have a pair of shoes out there like that at a remote gravel right. lake area.
Right. Unless they took them off when they went to put her in the water. Didn't want to get his shoes wet.
Jan says investigators told her they put up surveillance cameras at the scene after the murder.
Well, and Jeremy put one or two cameras out there and got about 2,000 pictures afterwards, thinking sometimes they come back to the scene. And I guess nothing became of that either.
Alicia's fishing pole was never found.
A year later, Alicia's purse was discovered on a sandbar with her cash and items intact inside. However, her cell phone was missing.
Investigators have not released Alicia's autopsy to her family, saying it may contain information only the killer would know. The manner in which she was killed also holds clues that could eventually break the case.
A cutting.
Cutting.
Yep.
With a scissors, a knife, or?
Well, we don't have that information.
And the blunt force, she was hit by something?
Yeah.
But you don't know what?
I can't tell you.
You do know?
Yes.
Yeah. So you know you have the murder weapon, you know what it was?
I can't really discuss that at this point.
Her family believes she put up a fight because of what they noticed at her funeral.
They had her hands folded, and we could see that one of her fingers was broken. So we knew that she struggled. I am assuming it was to hang on to that phone. That phone was her Bible. It had everything in it.
And her family believes Alicia's fingers may have also contained her killer's DNA.
Her fingernails were all black from where they had checked for DNA, I'm sure. But she wasn't in the water that long, so there should be some DNA from somewhere.
Obviously, DNA evidence is valuable if the opportunity ever comes up with something like that.
Because you do have DNA evidence that you could...
We have a lot of evidence, but I can't really tell you what we have.
Right, but if you could match someone's DNA...
Ideally, yes. Ideally, we would match DNA.
Bethany says the loss of her friend has left a void in her life. Alicia missed out on the births of Bethany's children. She runs a Facebook page, Fighting for Alicia, where she keeps her best friend's story alive.
We're going to fight for Alicia until Alicia gets justice.
I just want the truth. Like, I want to know who did it, who was there, who watched, who, you know, beat her up, whoever, you know, like, I just want to know.
What do you miss most, maybe, about not having, you know, what do you...
My best friend. I miss my best friend.
There is a $5,000 reward offered for anyone with information leading to an arrest in this case. That poster hangs in the booking area of the Clay County Jail. Sheriff Howe says he hopes someday it triggers a memory in someone coming into the jail who may know something about Alicia's death.